It's 10 to 9. It's been almost, would you believe, 20 years since McFly first burst onto the music scene as teenage heartthrobs. I'm sure they're still heartthrobs. They captured the attention of millions, of course. A lot has changed in that time for them, but the hits are still coming.
Back with new music and a mission to save the guitar. We'll get them to explain what that means. We'll talk to them in a moment. First, though, here's a reminder of some of their hits. So, Tom, Danny, Dougie and Harry join us now. Good morning.
Good morning.
So, you were looking at your haircuts and what, not enjoying it or looking
song,
back?
Well, that last song was during lockdown, so I... Yeah.
What was a lockdown haircut?
It was a lockdown haircut.
What does that mean? Did you
Lack of haircut.
Oh, right.
Yeah, it was dodgy.
You didn't trust anyone to do it for you?
We weren't allowed out of house,
no. No, you could cut your own hair. I cut my own hair.
Did you?
Yeah. My partner's.
Did you?
Yeah. Not today.
No, she's not responsible for that. No, yeah, she could do with cutting it. Give me a trip. She was good.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah, all new skills.
Yeah.
How are you all doing?
We're doing really, really good, thanks.
What's this?
You split us up.
Yeah.
Well,
we've joined the band.
Well, the thing is, you can't split us
Which
up.
Is the better side, Naga?
Oh, your side, definitely.
Yes, right. Oh, yeah.
Who is this competitive?
Tell us about Saving the Guitar, then. What's all this about?
Well, Saving the Guitar, well, yeah, I feel like... this album's been amazing to make, this single particularly, because we've always kind of found it that we've almost chased radio a little bit too much, and this is the first one that we've kind of been like, we got our own studio in lockdown, and that was the best thing we ever did, and it allowed us to just be a band, you know, again, because normally you go into a studio, you've got me and Tom and Dougie will write, like, on the acoustic guitars, maybe, do the demo, and go into a studio, then you've got, like, kind of time to make this album, whereas this time we had our own space. Yeah, this time we had our own space, and it kind of allowed us to be this kind of band that we've always been, you know?
Is the music better now you're not, excuse me, chasing radio?
I'd say, yeah. I think, as Danny said, like, there's always that stress and pressure of being in a band of, like, what kind of music should we be doing? But I think this time when we set out making this album, we just decided let's just make the music that we want to do. And
so did it change the dynamic of how you were making music as well, knowing that you didn't have that
pressure, and that
formula to, not all a formula, but, you know, the kind of tick boxes?
Yeah, and options are, like, limited when you're making music, but when we just stripped it back to our instruments, it just became a lot clearer for us, and we were just writing songs, setting up as a band and playing. And you know, we decided as a band that that was the thing that was important to us. And, you know, and then that night, Tom went away, came back and was like, I have this song. It's called Where Did All the Guitars Go? And
you wrote this on your steering wheel, if I remember correctly.
I write when I'm driving my car, so I live back.
Can we just say, OK, we're watching BBC Breakfast, children watching, do not follow Tom's example. anything on your steering wheel.
He didn't literally write it.
No, not write it, just like sing it. When I drive, I don't have any music on and I sing and I speak out loud.
And that's when I
come up with a lot of ideas. It's the only peace I get is when I'm on my own in the car.
And then do you find that you forget what you might have done half an hour ago on the journey? Or
sometimes. I think the good ideas stick most of the time. Or I'll have to kind of send it to someone, you know, once I get to wherever I'm going. But it was just interesting because we did this exercise where we wrote McFly on this whiteboard and we had to write words of what McFly meant to us and what we wanted the album to be. And we hadn't really written a song that, you know, had really inspired us. And the one common word was guitars. And it was driving home from that kind of exercise.
It's like a non-digital cloud, isn't it?
A brainstorm.
Yeah. Well, you spoke about it, so let's take a look at the video. This is the video, and it's an exclusive first look at Where Did All the Guitar Goes?
Still McFly, though, isn't it?
Yeah,
isn't it?
Well...
It's sound, I suppose, yeah. It's singing.
Where was that?
That is in our studio. That's in the live room. We gutted the studio and built a box and made a video.
Whose idea was that?
Mine.
And when you say we built a box, did you actually build a box?
Oh, hell no. Oh, God, no.
You got someone who did.
Yeah.
What was their faces like when you said, right, the video's going to be in a box?
Very uninspired.
Doug's like our creative director. Doug comes up with like a lot of the the vision for the artwork and the music videos.
When have you kicked back?
Rarely.
Constantly.
Rarely. I can't be bothered. He kicks off. It's his way.
They don't like
way.
The X-rated stuff.
When we were talking before we started, Doug, you were saying that the other three have all got children, and your children are growing now.
Yeah.
And as they grow, they kind of find out what dad does for a job. I mean, how's that, Harry?
Yeah, it's great. My kids love it. Like, I'm sure the other guys would agree. You know, last summer, they started coming to a lot of the festivals we were playing, and, you know, my son has just got his guitar on the whole time, listening to the new songs.
How old is he?
He's 5. He exclusively listens to McFly, so I'm making the most of that until he realises that.
Really?
Yes.
So you're narrowing his
musical... No, not me.
Musical...
When we're in the car, he's like, it's McFly only, Dad. You have to pick a McFly song. Tom's kids, Cooper sings, Tom's kids play guitar,
There's
drums.
A new band coming in.
There is, they all play, it's great.
Yeah.
I think that's the thing with this album for us. We want to, you know, be that gateway band. We want kids to be inspired and pick up guitars. And there's nothing better than seeing kids in our audience with their... Because a lot of our fans have kids now showing them the way.
That's what it was like for me and Danny. We both have videos of us when we were like 5. Playing guitar and like playing our little toy guitars. Like it started that young. Like,
inspired by whom? Or who?
All sorts.
Yeah, for me. Well, my dad, mainly. My dad played guitar, so...
But also, there was
guitars around the house.
There was also a time, though, and it makes me sound really old, because I played musical instruments as well, when you could do it in school. And there's a lot less of that available because of funding issues, etc. So it's kind of like encouraging parents as well as children to pick up an instrument and kind of take that
That's a really good point, because if it wasn't for my mum getting me private guitar lessons, I wouldn't be doing what I did now, you know? Mm. And it wasn't exactly the same. My school didn't really put enough effort into the creative side of it. And it's sad. You know?
How about you, Dougie?
They had a rock school at my school.
What?
Amazing!
We had School of Rock.
Did you not know this?
Yeah.
What?
No.
Yeah.
He doesn't talk.
Perfect guest for the breakfast show. Tell us about the rock school.
Yeah. It was after school. You showed. It was just guitars, drums, and bass, and that was where I and actually the teacher there was the guy who helped me with my learning the McFly songs when I was auditioning.
Really?
His name What's was Alistair. His name?
Alistair.
Yeah, Alistair. I hope his name was Alistair.
Shout out to Alistair. Man. It's all thanks to Alistair. Yeah.
You didn't know this?
Not a clue.
No.
I did.
We learned
did
something
you?
Yeah, he
time.
Came to... Because originally it was Tom, then Danny, then I joined, and we were trying to find a bass player. And Dougie came to the studios and played with us, and when he left that day, he asked for our autographs.
Oh, that's really sweet.
Hey, businessman.
So I've never... Yeah, we never let him forget that.
That's fantastic. Hey. And did any of the other guys who were in rock school, did any of them go on to...
No, they didn't.
They failed.
Alistair,
I don't know. No. I'm sure they've gone and done great things.
It's fantastic.
It's great you guys are all kind of back together and kind of owning it a bit. Yeah. Not more, but just owning it in a different way and getting a different message out.
Thank you all for coming in.
Thank you. OK, see if I can get the title right this time. McFly's new single, Where Did All the Guitars Go? Yes.
Yeah.
It's out now. And the latest album, Power to Play, will be out on the 9th of June.
Yeah, you're watching BBC Breakfast. It is 8:59.
Woohoo!